In today's 2 minute takeaway, I want to talk about working capital, what it is and how we can try and improve it. I'm Hilary O'Dwyer, founder of Catition Consulting, your virtual CFO. So working capital, it's always top of people's minds. Let's look at the technical definition of it. Working capital is all of your current assets, which is your cash and receivables and stock or inventory, less your current liabilities, which is your payables, super, ATO, etc. So that's your working capital. We want working capital to be positive, and we want it ideally to be greater than one. So we want the assets to be bigger plus than your current liabilities. Your working capital is a reflection of your short-term current financial health. So what we're trying to establish is, can you pay your debts as they fall due with your available resources? So ideally, we want to have a lot in cash so we can simply pay our creditors or suppliers. But we know that the problem with this is that we may have cash tied up in receivables and stock. So how can we free up some cash from our receivables? Well, we can, if possible, potentially push our customers to pay deposits. So it may be that you're doing a piece of set work and you say to someone, I want 50% up front and then 50% on completion, which is going to enable you to fund your subcontractors, if that's what you're using, or otherwise to start that work. And then you know then that when the work is finished, you get to invoice for the final amount. Now that's really going to assist with your cash flow. Another way would be to shorten your trading terms and to make it easier for customers to pay you. And that could be as simple as introducing a payment type like Stripe or something on your invoices. So people see it, they can do it, they can move on and get on with it. Another way of trying to free up cash from your receivables would be to factor your receivables. And this is by using a firm such as Waddle, who will essentially buy your invoices off you, release those funds to you, and then when the customer pays, they pay the firm and you pay a fee for that. That's a type of financing. So what are we doing with our payables? How are we going to try and manage those? So with our payables, we have ATO debt in there and we have all the suppliers. We want to try and extend those payment terms as much as possible. And this may not always be possible. You might want to get a working capital loan from a bank to try and fund some inventory purchasing, which you will obviously be purchasing your stock in advance of your revenue, which could be very cyclical and could be a huge outlay in the short term, but you know the revenue will come in. Now that's really, really common, but you need to have ATO portals that are clear and you need to have all of your accounts in order to be able to demonstrate that the strong revenue streams are there for the bank to go, yep, we know the cash is coming in, it's just a short-term funding issue. I wouldn't get caught up with the interest rates that are on offer for any of these things because it's a small price to pay for actually keeping trading. So really, it's a really difficult one to manage, but it's super, super crucial. And it's really important to keep an eye on it and to see where are we at and how's it looking. So as ever, reach out to your advisor if you need help with this. And I hope you have a great day.